Congress debate on this one, and he has promised they will fully brief Congress on the substance of the Iran deal in the weeks to come.
In this morning's cover story, as we've been telling you, a Philadelphia woman is in federal custody. Her name is Keona Thomas. Investigators say she was making plans to join ISIS. Federal prosecutors say she tried to travel overseas to join ISIS, making various posts on Twitter, aligning herself with terrorists. When Thomas bought a ticket to Spain, that's when officials made their move and raided her North Philadelphia home. Joining us now to talk more about the arrest and the war on terror, University of Penn Professor Ian Lustick. Good morning, Professor.
Good morning.
We appreciate you coming in. Folks, as we mentioned earlier, hundreds of people are reacting to this arrest on our Facebook page, and I want to read a couple of those comments. The first one from Kenya. She says, "Stop wasting our time. They're a disgrace. It's one thing to disagree with things your country is doing, but to go against, sell, or tell secrets to help or aid in killing people in this country, that's just treason." And John follows up, "This is nothing new. You'd be very surprised at how many hits the Philly Police Department gets for terrorist alerts." So, Professor, starting with that second comment, is there more of a kind of focus on this? Are there more threats, or are we just living in a different information age so we hear more about it?
We are living in a different kind of circumstance. The initial idea after 9/11 was that we were going to be attacked by sleeper cells in the United States, real dedicated terrorists activated by organizations abroad who spend their lives thinking about how to blow up buildings and hurt the United States for political reasons. Those people exist, and studies of them show that they're perfectly normal psychologically. What we see now is a different kind of thing. Those people are looking for loaded guns. Some of those loaded guns are airplanes, some are bombs, but they're looking for loaded guns. What we now have is, through social media and the internet, those groups able to find in the United States and Europe loaded guns. That is, people who are so disturbed and upset that they can find through social media a dramatic way to express their internal tensions, and they are this what's called a lone wolf terrorism threat, much more difficult in some respects and probably more prevalent.
Well, and especially, and you actually wrote a book on this and that whole concept of lone wolf. Now with social media, there are people who make threats, there are people who make comments. Where's the line between someone who's upset with this country and someone who actually is going to act on it?
Well, we have legal lines for that, and I don't think they're inappropriate. I think our law enforcement is able to track as best they can and to move when action is taken that endangers the United States, as they did in this case, apparently. I think the key thing here is to lower the number of people who are available for these kinds of messages, and that means strengthening a mental health system that has really abandoned thousands, if not tens of thousands, of Americans to find their way in a world where they feel furious, paranoid, anxious, and disturbed, and use social media and use these vivid images of heroism and struggle to find a way to express that internal fury. So I think this is a wake-up call for our mental health system as much as it is our security system.
When you talk about the mental health side of this and people who may be troubled as much as they are angry and violent, how far does the country, how far should the country go in prosecuting someone like Keona here in Philadelphia?
Well, I think it has to be a case-by-case situation, and people will have to be evaluated in terms of whether she is psychologically fit to stand trial. If she is, then she should stand trial. But I think we see in a lot of cases, the Jihad Jane case and others, that people who are put in prison or people who are going through disturbed times in their lives suddenly transform themselves into a kind of fanatic that is available for this type of a mission, quote unquote, sponsored from abroad. But this is really taking advantage of a gun that's already loaded, not of a person who's turned into a dedicated terrorist.
Yeah, Professor Lustick, we appreciate you spending some time with us. This is the third person in just a few days. So obviously this story is not going away.
No.
We'll continue to keep you informed. Thank you. And folks, we want to hear from you. We want to know what you think, your comments on this issue. It's all over social media. You can leave us Facebook comments. You can tweet. Just make sure you use the hashtag Fox29Weekend. Karen.
Thanks, Bill. 820-